Dear learners, in this video, we will discuss how sustainability initiatives of the organizations can be measured and reported. All of us are aware that traditionally, businesses were judged by the financial profits they make. In traditional accounting, they used to describe profit or loss of the businesses as the bottom line, as it used to appear at the end of the profit and loss count. And only one bottom line, that is profits, was considered to be the driving force for any businesses. But due to legal and government pressures, organizations today are assessed not by their profits alone, but also by their sustainability solutions. Two other bottom lines, namely societal and environmental impacts, have been brought in to assess the performance of companies along with profits. The triple bottom line method measures the organization in terms of social, environment, and economic sustainability. The phrase people, planet, and profit best describes the triple bottom line and the goal of sustainability. The term triple bottom line was first coined by John Elkington in 1994 and reported further in his book Cannibals with Forks, The Triple Bottom Line of 21st Century Business in 1999. Today, many non-profit, profit and government sectors have started using triple bottom line to assess their performance. The concept of TBL, as it is defined, seems easier to understand, but it is tough to practice because measuring the dimensions of people and the planet is quite difficult. Profit could be measured in terms of rupee or dollar value, but how could social health or environmental health of organizations be measured? Global Reporting Initiative, GRI, has developed guidelines to enable businesses to report and measure their social, environment, and economic impact. Let us now further discuss the three dimensions of TBL. Number one, social dimension. The social or the people bottom line addresses the interaction with human capital by organizations. According to the social bottom line, the businesses need to consider the interest and well-being of all people connected with them. People can include the raw material suppliers, labor, top management, and other stakeholders. Companies with societal interest try to give back to the community also. Following are some examples of how businesses could score on social sustainability. Not employing child labor, providing a safe work environment for workers, adopting fair hiring policies, provision of adequate healthcare to staff, ensuring fair salaries to workers, providing opportunities for training and development, and not practicing any form of human trafficking would enhance the social score of businesses. However, it is quite difficult to measure this dimension as it is more subjective in nature. The GRI has developed guidelines in order to enable businesses to report and measure their social impact. The second one is environmental sustainability. The environment or planet bottom line refers to the natural capital and the sustainable environmental practices followed by the organizations. Environment sustainability refers to managing, monitoring, and reporting the consumption of resources, waste, and emissions. Companies focusing on this aspect recognize the need for going green, which would provide them with profitability in the long run. Following are a few planet-friendly practices. Using renewable energy, recycling of waste materials, reuse of materials, safe disposal of toxic materials, reduced carbon and other hazardous gas emissions, and limited use of water and other natural resources. The last dimension of TBL is economic sustainability. The economic or profit bottom line deals with the economic value created by the organization after deducting the cost of all inputs. It is not the profit as per traditional accounting, rather it is the real economic impact created by the organization on its economic environment. Following are few sustainable economic practices. Helping local suppliers stay in businesses, focus on overall supply chain profitability, fair payment to employees, the right choice of input materials. Having seen the three dimensions of TBL, let us also discuss the benefits of TBL. This approach ensures transparency and accountability of the organization. It builds reputation among consumers and the general public. TBL enhances productivity and reduces operating cost. It provides competitive advantage to the organization. It enables to retain the best talented workforce and provides avenues for new markets. It further helps in increasing market share and encourages corporate social responsibility reporting. Having seen the benefits, let us discuss a real case example that has used TBL approach. The multi-business player ITC delivers a triple bottom line with ₹11,200 crores of profit after tax in the financial year 2018 and has also achieved other standards in accordance with Global Reporting Initiative. ITC has been carbon positive for 13 consecutive years, water positive for 16 consecutive years, and solid waste recycling positive for the past 11 years. It has set up 23 platinum certified green buildings and has created 6 million livelihood opportunities. The company does intensive watershed development and large-scale afforestation. ITC has also reduced energy and water consumption significantly, thereby it has achieved triple bottom line success in a larger way. To conclude, the triple bottom line approach focuses on profit, people, and planet, and this approach has significantly changed the way businesses assess their performance. TBL needs long-term commitment and innovation by the organizations. The measurement of people and profit dimension poses a big challenge to organizations adopting TBL. However, the framework is quite flexible to incorporate the specific needs of the organizations. Therefore, the TBL framework, amidst its challenges, enables organizations to have sustainable growth in the long run. In the next video, we will discuss about ways and means of enhancing sustainability in organizations. Thank you.